Hello, good morning dear students. Again welcome back to our lesson that is Cell, the fundamental unit of life. Along with various other parts, now we are looking for the important cell organelles. Okay, cell organelles are playing an important role into the cell because so that only the cell is called as SWOT, structural and functional unit of life. So step by step and day by day we are looking for every cell organelle. And today's our topic is Golgi body, Golgi apparatus, or it is also called as Golgi complex. It has another names also. As we will move ahead into this topic, we will let you know what other names are given for the Golgi apparatus according to its discovery and according to its observation by various scientists. Okay, students. So this Golgi apparatus is actually a membrane-bound cell organelle. Means it has a membrane around it. Okay, and these are only found into the prokaryotic cell. These are mainly found into the eukaryotic cell. Into the prokaryotic cell, Golgi apparatus or Golgi bodies are absolutely absent, not present at all into the prokaryotic cell. Only they are found into the eukaryotic cell. But there is also one exceptional case where those are not present actually. Students, mammal means what you are doing. So into the mammalian cell, there is RBCs, or those RBC means what? Red blood corpuscles or red blood cells. Those are also called as what? Erythrocytes. So into the mammals, into the erythrocytes or into the RBCs, this Golgi apparatus is not at all present. Okay, this is all about plants, animals. And into the plant cell also, these are not present. In which kind of plant cell these are not present? Students, you are knowing CO2 filaments. As we will learn for the lesson tissue, that time CO2 means what you will come to know. So we will talk a lot during that lesson. If you will talk now, then into the CO2 filaments, this Golgi apparatus is absolutely absent. It is not present. Golgi apparatus are not present into the plant cell of the CO2 element. Okay. As well as these are not also present into the male gamete of the pteridophytes and the bryophytes. Pteridophyta and bryophyta, what it is that we will discuss, we will have the classification of the living organism. We will have a huge lesson in that classification, bifurcation, and how the animals and plants are sorted out, on what basis, that we will learn. So that time it will be clear for you what is meant by bryophytes and pteridophytes. But that time I shall explain you. But now you keep in mind that in male gametes of plant cells such as bryophytes and pteridophytes, this Golgi apparatus is not present. Okay, so this was the introductory part, actually, where it is present. Into the prokaryotic cell these are not present only, but in eukaryotic cell these are present except this plants, plant and the animal cell. Okay, students, now we will move ahead with the discovery of the Golgi apparatus. So the first scientist to discover or to observe the Golgi apparatus is what? George. Golgi body was first observed by George, who was one scientist. George. Okay. Later on, its morphological structure means its outer structure. Morphological structure was discovered by Camillo Golgi. Okay. Morphological structure was discovered by whom? Camillo Golgi. And by his name only, the name for this cell organelle is given Golgi body or Golgi apparatus, because he has discovered. Where he discovered? He discovered this Golgi apparatus into the nerve cell of cat. Means he tried to find out, for his experiment, he took a nerve cell of a cat, and in that he found first morphological structure of Golgi apparatus. Okay, and the name of this scientist is what? Camillo Golgi. So he has given the name for this cell organelle, Golgi body or Golgi apparatus. Later on, the microscopic structure or ultrastructure, the ultrastructure of this Golgi body or Golgi apparatus is discovered by Dalton. The structure was discovered by whom? By Dalton. So this is also called as what? Dalton's body. This is also called as what? Dalton's body. Or students, this is also called as the lipochondria. This Golgi apparatus or Golgi body is also called as what? Lipochondria. Mitochondria, student, you are knowing. So this is also called as what? Lipochondria. So this is all about the discovery of the Golgi apparatus or the Golgi body. I said you where it is present, where it is not present, and who was the first scientist to observe, that is George. Then morphological structure was found by Camillo Golgi, and so that this cell organelle, the name is given Golgi body or Golgi apparatus. Then and where he found into the nerve cell of a cat, understood, and there he found some organelle which is called as a Golgi apparatus. Later on, ultrastructure of this Golgi body was observed first by the Dalton. So this is also called as the Dalton's body, as well as it is also called as the lipochondria. Why it is called lipochondria, that we will see very soon. Okay, so this is all about the introductory part. If you talk about the size of the Golgi body or the Golgi apparatus, see, the main function of this Golgi body is not secretion. The secretion is the major function of the Golgi body. It may be of the lipids, it may be of the proteins, it may be of the digestive enzymes, or it may be of some steroids, or it may be of some hormones even. So the main function of the Golgi body is to secrete something, enzymes, hormones, understood, proteins, lipids. So this is mean secretory cell organelle. And wherever in our body the secretion is taking place, that time the size of this Golgi body is bigger. Okay, means if it is functioning well, then that particular Golgi apparatus would be bigger in size. Now where it will be bigger in? It will be bigger in size in liver cell, liver and pancreas, pancreatic cell. In liver cell and into the pancreatic cell, the Golgi body or the Golgi apparatus would be bigger in size. Okay, and where it will be smaller in size? Where the organ is non-secretory. These are the main secretory organs, right? Secreting something, and the main function of the Golgi body is what? Secretion. So whenever there are some organs in our body which are non-secretory, there the size of the Golgi body is smaller. So smaller size in muscle cells, students. Smaller in size where? In muscle cell. Understood, students? So this is all about bigger in size into the liver and the pancreatic cell, and smaller in size into the non-secretory cells, that is muscle cells. Now students, if we will talk about the number of Golgi apparatus or number of Golgi bodies present into the plant and the animal cell. Just now we have talked about the size. If we will talk about the number of Golgi bodies present into the plant cell, then, or in animal cell, then that number is also variable. How? The size of the Golgi body is variable. Likewise, the number of Golgi bodies into the plant cell and into the animal cells are also variable. Means students, into the animal cell, into the every animal cell, there will be only one Golgi body. Okay, in animal cell, if you will talk about the number of Golgi bodies, present into the cell, then in animal cell only
one Golgi body is present in animal cell. Only one Golgi body. Only one Golgi body.
And if we talk about plant cell, into the plant cell, 6 to 12 Golgi bodies are present. How many students? 6 to 12 Golgi bodies or Golgi apparatus are present. Okay? And if we talk about the lower LG, LG students, you are knowing. If we talk about the lower LG, into the lower LG also, only one Golgi body is present. Only one Golgi body is present. And if we talk about the rhizoidal cell, okay, rhizoidal cell students, if we will talk rhizoidal cell, like chara or kara also you can say. As per your wish, you can pronounce it as a chara or kara. So rhizoidal cell, like chara, hundreds of Golgi bodies are present. Hundreds of Golgi bodies are present. Means what, students? The number of Golgi bodies are variable like its size. Size is also variable. Okay? Whenever it is functioning, the size will be bigger. Whenever it is non-functional, size will be smaller. Understood? Likewise, the number of the Golgi bodies into the plant cell and into the animal cells are different. See, students, one thing that I forgot to tell you just now, I remember that plant cell, whenever the Golgi bodies are present into the plant cell, which are freely found into the plant cell, then such Golgi bodies into the plant cell are called as what? Dictyosomes. Dictyosomes. What, student? Into the animal cell, these are called as the Golgi bodies only. But when these Golgi bodies are present into the animal cell, that are called as what? Dictyosomes. Understood? So this is all about the number of Golgi bodies present into the animal cell or the plants. And now, if we will talk about the location and position. And if we will talk about the location and position of the Golgi apparatus into the plant cell and into the animal cell, then this position is also variable, students. Okay? Into the vertebrates. Vertebrates. Into the vertebrates, the Golgi apparatus or the Golgi body is perinuclear, student. Into the vertebrates, it is perinuclear. Perinuclear means what, students? Near to the nucleus. Suppose this is the cell and if this is the nucleus, then the Golgi body will be found near to the nucleus. Understood? That is called as what? Perinuclear. Into the vertebrates, into the animals. Understood? Into the animals, vertebrates, this Golgi bodies are found near to the nucleus. And that term is utilized, that is called as what? Perinuclear. And if we will try to talk about the invertebrates and the plants, if we will talk about the invertebrates, invertebrates, invertebrates means what? Those who do not have a vertebral column, backbone, those are called as what? Invertebrates. Invertebrates means what? Who are having a backbone or the column, that is called as a column or backbone, we can say vertebral column, then that is called as a vertebrates. And invertebrates do not have a vertebral column, or there they will invertebrates or into the plants, the Golgi bodies are found into the diffused manner or into the scattered manner. Means suppose if this is the cell and if this is the nucleus, then these Golgi bodies are found freely into the cytoplasm. These are found freely into the cytoplasm. Understood, students? In the form of what? Diffused form, you can say, or into the scattered form, these Golgi bodies are found. And one interesting thing, students, here we have to understand that into surround the area which is surrounding the Golgi body is a crystal clear of cytoplasm. No other cell organelle is present into that area, and that area is called as what? The zone of exclusion. Zone of exclusion of cytoplasmic area. Understood? Means into the invertebrates or into the plant cells, this Golgi bodies are found into the diffused form or into the scattered form. Okay? Means they are not perinuclear, near to the nucleus. They are found freely into the cytoplasm. And the area which is surrounding that Golgi body is crystal clear. Crystal clear cytoplasm, nothing else is present. And that area is called as what? Zone of exclusion of cytoplasmic area. So this is all about what? Location or position. So we have talked about the introductory part. In that I said you the discovery and observation of the various scientists, and now we have talked about the size, then the number, and then location and the position of the Golgi body. Now we will talk about the structure of the Golgi apparatus. How the structure of the Golgi apparatus is designed, that we will see. But student, before moving ahead, I would like to remind you the nucleus. Students, we have seen there is a nucleus, and nucleus contains what? Nucleoplasm. Okay, nucleoplasm is present, nuclear membrane is present, as well as material, hereditary material in the form of DNA is present. Understood, student? Then, surround the nucleus, there is a nuclear envelope, there is a nuclear pore, and on that nuclear pore, there were many ribosomes were present. Understood? And the main function of the ribosome is to prepare proteins, student. And near to the nucleus, one of the important cell organelle that I said you, that is the PA of the cell or the PA of the nucleus. So that is endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, and endoplasmic reticulums were of two types. I said you endoplasmic reticulum means what? Cisternes are present, the structure of the endoplasmic reticulum, if you will go back and see. Okay, then tubules were present, as well as vesicles were present, right? So these tubules, these vesicles are the part of the endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is of two types, smooth endoplasmic reticulum and the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum was producing the protein. It's a site of the protein synthesis. Because it is rough because of the presence of the ribosome on it. And below the rough endoplasmic reticulum, there is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. There was absence of the ribosome on it, and which was secreting lipids. After it immediately, the part of the Golgi body starts. So before moving ahead, I wanted to know you this history about the other cell organelles such as endoplasmic reticulum, which was very important, because that history we will carry forward to see the structure of what? Golgi apparatus. Now students, we will talk about the structure of the Golgi body. How the structure of the Golgi body is designed. Just now I said you the function of the ribosome, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now we will talk about the structure of the Golgi body. Okay, this structure, this ultra structure or very microscopic structure was given by whom? Just now I said you, it is given by Dalton's. Okay, Dalton was one scientist. He has given the structure, microscopic structure of the Golgi body. Okay, so microscopic structure was given us, or he has observed, and he then said the structure is designed like this. So according to him, the structure is bifurcated. This microscopic structure is designed
into three parts. Three major elements are present to the Golgi apparatus. The first part is called as what? Cisternae. Cisternae. The second is called as vacuoles. And third part is called as vesicles.
Now, I say you, this is the microscopic structure, ultrastructure, which was designed, which was given by the Dalton. And he found three major parts of the Golgi apparatus. He said that cisternae means long bag were present. I will talk to you now. Cisternae, this is called as what? Cisternae. See, one minute, student. This is what? Cisternae. Second is vacuoles. Third is vesicles. So, major three parts are there for the Golgi body.
You can see, student, this is the bag-like structure with the swollen end. You can see, this is the bag-like structure with the swollen end, and this bag is not in a straight line, means it's not a straight line bag, or it's not a straight bag. It is little bit curved bag, you can see, students. It is little bit curved bag.
See, students, this is bag-like structure, and this bag-like structure, this is fluid-filled bag-like structure. What fluid is filling, that we will see. So, this is fluid-filled bag-like structure, and this bag-like structure is called as what? Cisternae. This is called as what? Cisternae. Or singular, it is called as a cisterna. Okay? So, this is bag-like structure. This is called as what? Cisternae. And you can see the swollen end of the cisternae, that is called as what?
Golgian. Golgian body. That is called as what?
Golgian body. The swollen part is called as what?
Golgian body.
And this is connected with the, this is connected, students. These channels are connected with each other. These channels are connected with each other. These cisternae are connected with each other to transport the material. Right, students? To transport the material, these are connected. I hope you understand. Okay? And so I think cisternae is clear for you. This is called what? Cisternae. This is oblong, spherical, not completely spherical, half spherical bags are present. And you can see these bags are not in a straight line. These are little bit curved bags. Understood? And those are called as what? Cisternae. And the end of the cisternae, you can see the swollen part, that is called as what? Golgian body. Understood? And you can see here, yes, little bit concave structure is present. This structure is what? Concave structure. And if you will see, this structure is convex structure. So, the structure of the Golgi body has a polarity. The structure of the Golgi body has polarity. Polarity, why? Two structures are present. Concave structure is present, which is little bit curved from inside. And this is the convex structures are present. Now here, students, one more thing. How many cisternae are present? Now, how many cisternae are present into the plant cell and animal cell? This is also variable. Into the animal cell, there are 6 to 8 cisternae are present. And into the plant cell, there are 10 to 12 cisternae are present. Please, student, keep in mind how many cisternae are present. Into the animal cell, there are 6 to 8 cisternae are present. And into the plant cell, there are 10 to 12 cisternae are present. But into the fungal cell, there is only one cisterna. Okay, there is only one cisterna is present into the fungal cell. Keep in mind, students. And if you will talk about the vacuoles, then vacuoles are the large bags. The large sacs are present. And these are present at the concave side
of the cisternes. Understood? These are the larger bag. Bigger size bags are called as what? Vacuoles. These are called as what? Vacuoles. Vacuoles. And these are bigger in size, students. And these are always present near to the inner side of the cisterna. Understood? And always. And what about the vesicles? Vesicles are the small bags. How these are the bigger bags? But the vesicles are smaller bags, and the smaller bags are present here at the convex side of the cisterna. These are at the convex side of the cisterna. These are smaller in size. These are bigger in size. Bigger in size if the bags are present, that are called as what? Vacuoles. If the bags are smaller, then it is called as a vesicles. Okay, the structure is called as what? Vesicles. Understood, students? Now I said you into the animal cell, the nucleus means the Golgi bodies are perinuclear. Means the Golgi bodies are present here to the nucleus. Okay, near to the nucleus, I said you. Students, you are knowing the Golgi bodies are present here, and these Golgi bodies are secreting their material such as proteins and lipids. Okay, and this face, students, one more thing, let me finish this. These are the Golgi bodies. We are near to the nucleus. Into the animal cell I am talking about, and into the animal cell these Golgi bodies are called as what? Perinuclear, means near to the nucleus. And students, we are knowing near to the nucleus one more important cell organ is present, that is called as endoplasmic reticulum. And the function of the endoplasmic reticulum is to synthesize protein and the lipids. Okay, now what will happen, student? This inner part is called as what? This phase is called as what? Transphase. This part, concave part, is called as what? Transphase or maturation phase. This is called as what? Maturation phase. And this convex side is called as what? Cisphase. This is called as what? Cisphase and formation phase. This is called as what? Formation phase. Now, students, as we can watch here, the endoplasmic reticulum is secreting proteins and the lipids. Now, what happens, students? And senior students, this transphase is always, so that it is called as a polarity, students. See, polarity, why it is said? Concave side, and this is convex side. Concave side is always towards plasma membrane. Towards plasma membrane. And convex side is towards nuclear membrane. So it has a polarity. It has been said that it has polarity, that concave side is always towards the plasma membrane and the convex side is near to the nuclear membrane. Okay. And attached to the nuclear membrane, what is present, student? Endoplasmic reticulum. Now, endoplasmic reticulum, into the form of vesicles, it will produce the material which it has to transport, or which it has to transport. What is that material? That material will be what? What might be present inside it? So, the material which is present here, what material is present here, student? Proteins are present. Then lipids are present. Lipids are present. Proteins are present. Some hormones are present. Some enzymes are present. Okay. So all those things are present into the vacuoles. That will be transferred by the vesicles into this cisternae. Now it will travel to the cisternae, right? It will travel to the cisternae. What will travel to the cisternae? Proteins and the lipids. And it will accumulate at the Golgi body. Here it will get accumulated. here it will get accumulated.
Means the packing of the proteins and the lipids will be taking place at the Golgian body. Not only packing students, it has secreted, but not only packing, but the modification of the secretory material will be also taking place. So this is the main function of the Golgi body. Secretion is the main function, as well as modification of the proteins and lipid is also taking place. Now what happens? Modification means what happens? We will see what happens exactly when it modifies. Secretion is the first important. Then modification means what happens, student? When these proteins will attach with the sugar, this is called as what? Glycoprotein. This is called as what? Glycoprotein. When these proteins are attached with the lipids that are called as a glycolipids. These are called as a glycolipids. Okay, proteins when it will attach with the sugar, this is called as a glycoprotein. Means it was first protein, but when it will attach with the sugar, then it is called as what? Glycoprotein. Means what, students? The modification has taken place or not? Yes, modification has taken place. As well as proteins when attached with the lipids that are called as a glycolipids. So in this manner, first it has secreted as a simple protein and lipids. Later on, here the modification of the lipids and proteins taken place, that is called as what? Glycoprotein and the glycolipid. And then that material is stored into the Golgian body. And from here, then it will attach with the small vesicles or vacuoles. It will attach with the vacuoles, and through vacuoles that material will pass into the plasma membrane. Means whatever the material has present, whatever the modified material was present, as per the need of the cell, that material will get diffused into the cell. This is one thing would happen. As per the need of the cell, if the cell is in need of the proteins, lipids, then that material will get scattered everywhere or diffused everywhere into the cell. Or the same material through selectively permeable membrane can go outside also. As per the need of the other cell, that material can transfer also to the other cell. Means inter and intracellular transportation of this material will be taking place. Understood? I hope it is clear for you what had happened exactly. So from here, the material was created, that is called as what? Formation phase or cis phase. Then material has transported from here, and it is not only transported, it has modified also. And after modification, it is going out through the Golgian body in the form of vacuoles, and those vacuoles are nothing but lysosomes, students. Because lysosomes contains hormones, lysosome contains digestive enzymes. Those are called as what? Lysosomes. Okay. So as per the need of the cell, that material will get transferred, and that is why this phase is called as what? Transphase or the maturation phase. Means the material can be scattered everywhere into the cell. So this is all about the structure. And if you will talk about the function of the Golgi body, then since long back, students, I am saying, what is the first function of the Golgi body? The first function is what? Secretion, right? Second, what had done? Modification of whom? Modification of protein and lipid. Modification of protein and lipid. Then packing. It has packed into the Golgian body. So packaging material. Packaging.
packaging, right? Packaging had done. And fourth one, what is the other function? Or packaging, or we can say storage also. Storage is also the function. Storage, understood? And the fourth function is what? Formation of lysosome. Formation of lysosomes. Understood? So this is all about the function of the Golgi body. Whenever you have understood the structure at that time only, you might have understood the function of the Golgi body. So this is all about the Golgi body. I hope you might have understood in detail the history, means the discovery of the Golgi body, as well as its size, its position, its location, its number, and then the structure and the function of the Golgi body. So go with it, prepare your own notes, which will be really helpful for you in future, and watch it really very carefully. And if you have doubts, students, you may ask me. Thank you so much.